So our next semi-final is men's singles, and Marc Schwebler, the left-handed German, the number three seed, up against the number 12 seed, Wong Wing Kee from Hong Kong. So here is Marc Schwebler, the 31-year-old from Bonn here in Germany. Today appearing in his sixth semi-final at this particular tournament. His fourth semi-final of the year. Recent winner of the Prague International, where he retained his title that he'd won last year. So for the home fans, this is last chance saloon with Marc Schwebler. And the man standing in the way is this man, the number 12 seed, Wong Wing Kee. 25 years of age. Well, Hong Kong have got two semi-finalists in the men's singles, because Ng Kar Long is contesting the semi-final in the top half of the draw against Rajiv Usif from England. But here in the bottom half of the draw, it is the left-handed Marc Schwebler against Wong Wing Kee. David von Schreven from Austria is our umpire for this one. Players change ends before the start of this semi-final. Well, Marc Schwebler was telling me yesterday that he's had an Achilles injury and he took 4 weeks off from training in an effort to try and get it better. But I have to say, he wasn't walking terribly well yesterday after his quarter-final against Su Jin Ho of Chinese Taipei. Well, I can tell you that there was three players from Chinese Taipei in quarterfinal stage and two from Hong Kong. And now we're down to the last four and we've still got two from Hong Kong. And of course, one of the players from Taipei was the three-time defending champion, Xiao Tian Chen. But here is the 31-year-old German who reached the final here in 2012 and 2013. Where he lost to the player I've just mentioned from Taipei, Xiao Tian Chen. This is his sixth semi-final in total. Has been as high as 10 in the world ranking, but he's down a couple of places this week to number 20 currently in the world rankings. The former European champion won the gold medal in 2012 in Karlskrona in Sweden. Well, as far as his opponent is concerned, well, he's 28 in the world ranking at the moment. In fact, he's the fourth ranked Hong Kong player. But he, like his opponent, has been very much higher. He's been as high as 12. Only making his second appearance here. Last year, he lost in the round of last 16 when he was the number 9 seed. And his only previous semi-final earlier this year, this man, was also here in Germany, also at a Grand Prix Gold event, the German Grand Prix Gold in March. Well, had a three-game quarter-final yesterday, did the player from Hong Kong when he played against Wang Su Wei, highly talented youngster from Chinese Taipei.
On my right, Wong Wing Kee, Hong Kong, China. And on my left, Marc Schwebler, Germany. One whiskey to serve. La ball. Play.
So the number 12 seed, Wong Wing Kee of Hong Kong, getting the semi-final underway. This is actually the third meeting between these two men. previous two meetings have both been won by the player from Hong Kong. But, of course, Mark Schwiebler, playing on home ground, will have the support of the home fans. The two previous meetings have both been either in Asia or the opposite side of the world. My goodness, what was that defensive shot? Oh, and then he misses. A wry smile from Mark Schwiebler. Look how short the lift is. Look where his feet are landing on the jump smash there. Way inside the double service line. And yet, smashes into the net. Oh, string's gone in the racket. Yeah, that's why he made the error, yeah, you can see that. Well, in his last three matches, Mark Schwiebler has been pushed the full distance in the second round against the qualifier. Another left-hander, Toby Plenty, who dropped the opening game there. And then in the third round against the number 14 seed, Chong Wei Feng, another left-hander, dropped the opening game there, as indeed he did yesterday against the number 8 seed in the quarterfinal, Su Jen Ho. So, Mark Schwiebler, well, it would all tie in with the injury problems and the difficulty in really getting going and getting warmed up properly, dropping the opening games. That must have taken its physical toll. Three matches going to three games in the last 3 days. Just apologises for the good fortune. It's going wide. These are both players, in my opinion, that are much better than their rankings suggest. I remember Wang Yingping beating Lin Dan in the second round of the Denmark Super Series going back 4 years. He's also beaten the likes of Chen Jin, former world champion, Li Hun Il, former world number one, Du Peng Yu. Three games twice against the former world number one, Li Chong Wei. He's a player that time and time again is a threat to the big names. Never won a title. Wang Wingfei, four finals he's been in. And I think that's part of his problem. He can beat anybody on his day, but doing it day after day after day to get all the way through the tournament, five or six matches on the bounce, that's the difficulty for him. Well, seven straight points for the German. Nice net play. Oh, yes. The acute angle. Well, after that hideous miss very, very early on where he smashed into the net, Mark Schwiebler. Well, since then he's been brilliant. 8 straight points, 9 straight points.
10-2.
Oh, that was a little bit sloppy, a little bit arrogant, so perhaps. Trying to put the top spin and create extra disguise and deception. Good attack, good use of the body smash.
4-10.
Yeah, right into the middle of the chest. Yeah, he gives him the thumbs up. That's nice to see, good sportsmanship. Acknowledging his opponent's good play. Another good rally from Wong Wing Ki. He's actually born Wong Shu Ki. At age 17, changed his name because Shu in Chinese means loser. Oh, that's lovely. Lovely play from Wong Wing Ki. He's also a great musician, actually, this man from Hong Kong. Plays the piano very well. Actually likes to play the piano before a big match. It helps him to relax. Oh, good rally. Oh, it was so tight, the net shot, that Mark Schwiebler, despite being there, couldn't make the kill. Well, it was 10-2 when Mark Schwiebler tried a topspin, and I said, well, that was sloppy and perhaps a little bit arrogant. And since then, he's lost 5 straight points, and all of a sudden, his opponent feels he's back in this opening game. And lesson in why it's important to keep the intensity the whole way through. Cannot afford to let off and let up for one moment. Oh my goodness me. Wow, this is extraordinary. Yeah, fans getting a little bit worried now. But Mark Schwiebler has the advantage at the mid-game interval. But it is only 3 points, and when you consider he was 10-2 up, he really, really allowed his opponent back in.
Wichtig ist, dass du immer wieder die Balance findest. Zwischen gute Beine, frühe Treffpunkte, ihn gut bewegen auf die Chance warten. Dann haben wir Fehler gemacht. Ja? Und das geht nicht um die Ecken, das geht um die Treffpunkte und dann ein, zwei Mal Tempo anziehen, dann aber wieder ruhig spielen. Dann fängt er an, die Fehler zu machen. Nach dem Tempo nicht ganz gut.
So the German coaches, Holger Hasser, is the head coach for the German team. And Wang Shuyong, Chinese coach there. Oh, what a difference he's made to the German players with their net play, especially. Chinese coach A number of Chinese coaches came to Europe a few years ago, helped the development of badminton here in Europe. Oh, that's a good net shot. Good lift, too. It's gone wide. Corners of the court, brought forward, pushed back, brought forward. Yeah, both men playing very well in that rally. And that looked a little bit laboured, though, that lunge forward from Zwiebler. It long.
14-8.
So Mark Zwiebler has got 14 titles throughout his career. Never won a Grand Prix gold event.
Service over 9-14.
Never won a Super Series either, despite being in two finals, 2009 Denmark and 2013 Indonesia. Oh, look at that. That's gone long.
10-14.
Oh, yes. Lovely. And there's never adverse to throwing himself around the court, Zwiebler. It's always good to watch, and the dive. And he is a great retriever of the shuttle. There's no doubt about it. But not on that occasion. Doesn't have to be full power. And the fans here in Saarbrücken very acutely aware that this is just a critical little phase of this opening game. Very important that Zwiebler keeps a few point cushion in front of Wong Wing Ki. Noticing that because there's no Hong Kong coaches here, that the women's doubles pair that we've just seen, helping Lok Yan. You can see Ying Sui. They're in the coaches' chairs at the back of the court, waiting to give advice to Wong Wing-Ki. Well, that's extraordinary. They just finished their match. They've got a final tomorrow, but still supporting us. Another brilliant, brilliant net shot. Oh, that's a nice touch.
13, 16.
Look at that. And again, the thumbs up. yeah, that's nice. Lovely. Sportsmanship alive and well in the sport of badminton. Good retrieving. Overdone it.
Serves over.
Yeah, the perspiration left. There they are. There's our women's doubles pair contesting the final tomorrow. That's great to see them still supporting their teammates with the lack of a coach here. And I noticed yesterday they were doing the same thing. They played their quarterfinal and they were looking after the men's singles players. Good team spirit. The players from Hong Kong. That's unbelievable defense, isn't it? Well, I can tell you, Mark Schreiber's just made an error on the next shot. So it's now, in fact, 15-18. My goodness! All out attack from the former European champion. The backhand kill at the net.
Serves over 19-15.
This one here, look at that. Well retrieved initially from Wong Wing-Ki. Is where you've got to hold your nerve. He's got the character to do so. Oh, indecision. Regret that sloppy shot when 10-2 up in this first game. because he really allowed from that moment his opponent back into this match. Oh yes. Calm in the crisis. Looked as if he was going to kill it, and then just the delicate little block. And now two game point opportunities for Mark Schwebler. Oh, well, takes the shuttle off the top of the tape. Hits his opponent in the face with the shuttle, for which he immediately apologises. But delight for the home fans, because Mark Schwebler has taken the opening game 21-18. 21-18. In just a little over 20 minutes. Oh dear, yeah. Just as well that didn't hit the eye. That could have been nasty. Well, up until that point, I thought that Wong Wing Kee had been getting the better of the net play. Ah, look at the work rate. Comes forward, takes it early, goes back in court, comes forward, takes it early again. Yeah. 21-18. Opening game to the two-time former finalist, Mark Schwebler. He's taken a new racket. There's Mark Schwebler. Just testing it out.
Second game. Double. Play.
Oh yes, that's good. Well, Mark Schwebler looks at the line judge. I think the line judge got that absolutely right.
One love.
Yeah, again he's turning and having a little look. That time it was out, no question.
Service over. One, all. Service over.
80. It's always a sign of players in trouble when they have to turn and play the backhand, especially when they take it as late as that. Corner, then takes it early, and what a difference when he's taking it early. Able to hit the winner. Yeah, took that early too. And again, a huge difference in the outcome.
3-2.
A little slow to get up there, Mark Schwiebler. I do hope he's all right. Let's have a look at this. Oh, yes, did the ankle almost went. Managed to save himself. Goodness, what a super drop shot.
5-2.
Skimmed the net as it went over. The second game has got a whole different feel to it. 7-2, the advantage. As we watch that again, outright winner, cross court smash from Wong Wing Kee. See the strapping on the right Achilles there. Yeah, Mark Schwiebler, I'm not sure. Yeah, he just felt that during that last rally. Yeah, well, he was saying to me that, you know, despite taking those 4 weeks off from training, still seem to be bothering him. Yeah, good work. And he really just mused and sort of said, well, I suppose that's one of the problems of getting older. Well, Lee Chong Wei, the former world number one who won the Super Series event in Paris last week, he's just turned 33. The current Olympic champion is 32. Mark Schwiebler's only 31. Oh, yes. Well, it's very similar to the opening game, isn't it? Only in favour of the opposite player. Mark Schwiebler was 10-2 in the opening game. Wong Wing Kee was 10-3. He's now 11-4.
So it's over 11-4. Interval.
So here come the women's doubles players to advise their friend and colleague. Now, that is very, very concerning, the fact that he needs to sit down, Mark Schwiebler. Not happy with himself, or perhaps not happy with his physical condition.
The
problem is, when you've got a niggling injury, It's so difficult to really play freely. But you do exactly that. You've got to say to yourself, well, if I carry on playing the way I've played the first half of this second game, I'm going to lose. Throw all caution to the wind. Just go for it. Nice drop shot. Oh, he's pushed it long.
Serve is over. 7-12.
Yeah, clearly long. Look at that. Oh, it's landed way in. That's a nice clear from Wong Wing Ki. Yeah, that's the problem of pushing off, isn't it, with a sore Achilles. A 7-point advantage at the mid-game interval. Winky. Yeah, that didn't look good, that movement from the former European champion. Take a look at this. Yeah. Didn't want to land on that right leg. Look. Yeah. Oh, yeah, that hurt. Good rally. But it was interesting that Mark Riebler trying to take the initiative and dictate the pace. That's a super drop shot. And going for the acute angle. But in my opinion, the German is struggling. Struggling physically.
Thank you.
Oh yeah, that's a nice shot. Oh, it's going wide. Oh yes, good rally. Very good rally. Both players playing well. In the end, I think Schwiebler just running out of steam. And that would also tie in with the fact he's had to take 4 weeks off from training. Thought several were going just wide of that sideline. The players were telling me there was a little bit of a drift, certainly earlier in the week when there was four courts in action. And I think Wong Wing Kee's taken a couple during this second game that were going to go wide of that sideline. Well, it looks very much as if we'll be treated to a third and deciding game. 8-point advantage, 18-10. Oh, that's lovely. Oh, I don't believe it! A little bit of trickery from Mark Schwiebler. Behind the back shot that was played to perfection. Look at this. Well, it was a lovely shot and a good kill. But look at that, that's extraordinary. Unbelievable, absolutely unbelievable. Points away from taking this second game. Wong Wing Kee. Now just 1 point needed to force a third and deciding game.
Game.
One game all. 21-12, that second game in favour of the number 12 seed, Wong Wing Kee. Score confirmed by the umpire. One game all after 38 minutes. And indeed, we will be treated to a third and deciding game. Doubles semi-final on the adjoining court. Thank you.
Ja, der macht ein paar gute Punkte, aber ich mache halt auch viele. Ja, waren diese 5-6 Schütze. Ja,
it is desperately important for Mark Schwebler to make a good start to this third and deciding game if he wants to keep the home fans happy. Last home success here at the Bitburger Grand Prix Gold was 2 years ago with mixed doubles pair, Mikkel Fuchs and Birgit Mikkels.
Final game, level.
So third and deciding game. Stop! Oh, what a good start by Wong Wing Kee.
One love.
In fact, the last German winner of the Bitburger Grand Prix Gold, you have to go back to 2000, long before this Grand Prix Gold started. Clapping in unison to try and support Mark Schwebler. Oh, he's pushed it long. I think if Schwebler can really take the sting out of the attacking play of Wong Wing Kee, and to do that he's got to push his opponent to the back, bring him forward, really make him work, but you can't afford to do it with loose shots. It's got to be fast clears, it's got to be deceptive drop shots. Ooh, that's a brilliant net shot. Now, if you can do that, of course, virtually impossible for your opponent to get it back.
Three, all.
Good to see the young fans. Seemed to mistime that. Oh, what's that? Come on, move the legs. Yeah, he didn't really get that left leg out. Got to not just get the racket arm out, but you've got to sort of push the lead leg, the lunge leg, out towards where the shuttle is going to land. Get yourself in position. Yeah, same problem there. And I wonder if it's because he can't push off with that right leg.
Five, three.
Because it's the power from the right leg that allows the left leg to go into that lunge position.
Oh!
Oh, yes, good rally. And a good final smash that leaves Mark Schriebler sprawled across the court. Yeah, and a little grimace on the face too. This is a big point. This is crucial. Oh, yes, and that's well taken by the home player, Mark Schriebler. Good lift. Yeah. Well, Schriebler is feeling the pace of this. Yeah. He looked more and more tired as the rally went on, and that final shot to me looked to look at that, didn't recover properly, and then desperate to try and play a winner, tries to play a disguised perfect net shot and makes the error. I didn't like that. There was some awkward movement there from Mark Schriebler. Oh, my goodness, he almost hit his head on the net post there. Well, you can't ever accuse him of lack of effort. Look at this. Look at that movement. I didn't like that at all. Oh, and then he goes awfully close to the net, but almost falls over. Refuses to give up. Oh, crikey, that was close. I remember a few years ago, James Blake, American tennis player, voted at the time as one of the sexiest men in world sport. And he skidded into the net post on the tennis court and broke his neck. Crikey, we can't have anything like that. Yeah, somebody's taking flashlight photography at the back of the court. Stop that immediately. Yeah, very distracting for the players. He's a tired, tired man. He's the former European champion.
everything okay?
No, we'll get it.
Yeah, yeah, thank you.
And the umpire getting involved on the discussion to change the shuttle or not, and that's nice. Little acknowledgement, a little bit of a misunderstanding between the two players. Oh, clever. Oh my goodness, how did he do that? And the frustration in the end, because on a run of five straight points, Wong Wing Kee of Hong Kong has a 7-point advantage at the change of ends in this deciding game. Look at this. Great defence initially, wasn't it? Off his knees. And there, the frustration. Oh, how did he get out of the way to play that? Goodness me. Sometimes see that in doubles. Rarely do you see a player playing defensive shots off their knees in men's singles. Now, what's he got left? How much stamina? How much energy? And most important, how much belief? Always difficult when you come back from injury or come back from an absence from the sport. Do you believe? Confident. Ooh. Oh, that came off the racket frame and went over. Yeah, the confidence is such a fragile thing in any sport, isn't it? Oh, behind the back again. Yeah, he's down, and I don't think he's that far from being out. It's desperation now from the German. The behind the back, and in the end it was to no avail. It's gone wide. Now or never, as far as Rybla is concerned. He's got to start closing the gap. 13. Oh, that's delightful. Yeah, Schwiebler didn't even move. 14. Great disguise 7. And good angle too. Well, it's 11 months 15. since Wong Wing-Ki was last in a final. That was the Macau Grand Prix gold at the end of last year. Lost that final in Macau to Chui Shong of China. Oh. And Wong Wing-Ki is on a roll right here.
16-7.
He can sense victory. Yeah, one just sort of feels that that was perhaps the last resistance from Schwiebler. Smash into the net, yeah. His opponent with a 9-point advantage and only needing another 4 points to get through to his fifth ever final in international badminton. Oh. Well, I said earlier, this man Schwiebler doesn't know about the word quit. Give up. The opportunity was there. Wong Wing-Ki had been forced to take the shuttle late.
18-9.
It was a loose net shot. That was a brilliant net shot from the German. Loose, and it's gratefully received.
11-18.
Puts that away with venom. Good retrieving. Yeah.
Service over.
Court attendance quickly on to mop up the perspiration. German coaches, well, they look resigned to defeat as well, don't they?
19-11.
So 2 points away from our place in the final, Wong Wing-Ki. Oh, he's just missed it. Yeah, I've got good sight down that line. And that
20,
missed by a whisker.
Point,
9 match point opportunities for Hong Kong's Huang Wing-Ki. Yeah, that'll do. First time of asking. And Huang Wing-Ki of Hong Kong is through to the final. His first final for 11 months. Heartache once again for the home player, Mark Schwebler. How many more chances will he have, the former European champion? Twice he's reached the final, but on both previous occasions he fell short. He's fallen short this year in semi-final stage. He's lost to the better man today, and the better man was Huang Wing-Ki. 18-21, 21-12, 21-11 in a match lasting an hour and 1 minute. The players take leave of the court. Yeah, big sigh of relief as well as happiness as far as Huang Wing-Ki is concerned. Will he win his first ever title tomorrow? Well, that remains to be seen. And will it be an all Hong Kong final? Because Ng Kar Long is up against Rajiv Yusuf in the other semi-final. And that, as you can see, is yet to be played. So our fourth semi-final of the day, we turn our attention to doubles once again. This time it's mixed doubles. And the married couple of Chris and Gabrielle Adcock of England, they're up against Jaco Arens and Selina Peek of the Netherlands. Here the married couple, Chris and Gabby Adcock, number one seeds. And former finalists here at the Bitburger Grand Prix Gold. Reached the final 2 years ago when they were the number two seeds.